Honorable Prime Minister of India, I may take the liberty to call you Narendra Bhaiji. Distinguished dignitaries present here.
राज्यसभा के सांसद एवं सीनियर एडवोकेट कपिल सिब्बल का प्रधानमंत्री मोदी और सीजीआई चंचूण के बीच दिया गया एक भाषण काफी तेजी से वायरल हो रहा है। कपिल सिब्बल ने अपने भाषण में जिला अदालतों और सेशन कोर्ट को सशक्त बनाने के महत्व पर जोर दिया। डिस्ट्रिक्ट जुडिशरी के दो दिवसीय राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन के उद्घाटन समारोह को संबोधित करते हुए कपिल सिब्बल ने कहा कि इन अदालतों को अधीनस्थ नहीं बल्कि न्याय प्रणाली के महत्वपूर्ण घटकों के रूप में देखा जाना चाहिए। और सबसे खास बात यह रही कि कपिल सिब्बल जब यह बात कह रहे थे तो उनके सामने चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया डीवाई चंचूड़ और प्रधानमंत्री मोदी भी वहां मौजूद थे। भाषण की शुरुआत करते हुए कपिल सिब्बल ने प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी की ओर देखकर कहा कि क्या मैं प्रधानमंत्री जी को नरेंद्र भाई जी कहने की आजादी ले सकता हूं? हालांकि इस दौरान प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी ने कुछ खास प्रतिक्रिया नहीं दी, लेकिन कपिल सिब्बल के आजादी मांगने के सवाल पर पीएम मोदी ने जो भी प्रतिक्रिया दी वो वायरल हो गया। हालांकि पूरा भाषण अंग्रेजी में है, लेकिन हिंदी अनुवाद के साथ कपिल सिब्बल का पूरा भाषण प्रस्तुत कर रहे हैं, तो हिंदी अनुवाद के साथ कपिल सिब्बल का पूरा भाषण देखिए।
Honorable Prime Minister of India, I may take the liberty to call you Narendra Bhaiji. Distinguished dignitaries present here, I feel honored and privileged to be present here at the National Conference of the District Judiciary to mark the 75th year of the establishment of the Supreme Court of India. Any structure with a weak foundation will impact the edifice and eventually collapse. The justice delivery system at the foundation of the judicial structure needs to be strengthened both in terms of quantity and quality of manpower and infrastructure. Our trial court and district and session courts need to be empowered to deliver justice without fear and favor. Unless people at the bottom of the pyramid have the ability to withstand the pressure, the superstructure of the polity will not be able to deliver. I don't want to call the judiciary at the level of the trial court and district and session judges to be subordinate, because the judge sitting there delivers justice, and the question of being considered as subordinate to any authority is a contradiction in terms. The judiciary at that level should be instilled with the confidence that their judicial pronouncements shall never be held against them, and that they represent the spinal cord of the justice delivery system. They should have the flexibility and the independence to render judgments in accordance with law without fear or favor. The effectiveness, fairness, and integrity of the courts impacts the perception of the public on the credibility of the entire judicial system. The fact that the trial court and district and session courts are loath to grant bail in matters of some significance itself is symptomatic of the malaise that has set in. In the course of my career, I have seldom witnessed the grant of bail at that level. This is not just my experience, but the Chief Justice of India has said often enough that court at the highest level is burdened with matters of bail, because at the level of trial courts and district and session courts, bail seems to be an exception. Of course, it goes without saying that the grant of bail depends on the facts and circumstances of each case, but the pronouncements of the court have in the recent past adhered to the principle that bail is the rule and jail an exception. We've seen trends harking back to the law laid down in Gurbakhsh Singh Sibiya, wherein this principle has been enunciated and has now been reiterated by the Supreme Court of India in several recent judgments, even in relation to special acts which require stringent twin conditions. Liberty is the foundational substratum of a thriving democracy. Any attempt to throttle it impacts the quality of our democracy. Moving away from liberty, we need to address the problems being faced by trial courts and the district and sessions courts, which impede the quality of the justice delivery system. The judge population ratio in India is abysmally low 21 judges to a million population, as compared to over 100, and in Europe, over 200 judges to a million population. Therefore, the roster at the level of the trial and district and session courts is overburdened on a daily basis, which impacts not just the justice delivery system, but lives of millions who are waiting for justice to be delivered. They come to court day in and day out for their matters to be heard expeditiously and fairly. However, in the absence of quick disposals, they have to wait for years, which impacts them both economically and mentally. The court cannot even imagine the mental agony and the economic consequences of these kind of delays. Furthermore, our young, talented people choose not to seek appointments at the trial and district sessions courts due to abysmal conditions in which judges operate. Despite this, many of the judges, through sheer hard work and commitment to the cause, are doing yeoman service to the nation, even though they are handicapped by lack of proper courtrooms and office facilities, supporting staff, including stenographers, library facilities at home, appropriate residential accommodation, and necessary transportation facilities. Needless to mention, the meager salary that those serving the cause of the nation draw to discharge their duties. Unless we are able to improve their conditions of work, both in terms of salary and infrastructure, the quantity and quality of the justice delivery system will suffer. Some of the problems that need to be addressed are the following, and I will not elaborate on them. Pension. Despite the fact that the Supreme Court had accepted recommendations of the Shetty Commission and subsequently the Padmanabhan Committee, the NPS was made applicable to judges of district courts from 2005 without even consulting the high courts. The major disadvantage of NPS, that the monthly annuity provided to judicial officers after retirement is much less than the pension that a judicial officer having the same length of service and having retired from the same rank receives. Under the NPS, the retired judge gets a monthly annuity, in some cases to as low as 13,965, as against 1,63,000 under the old pension scheme. Promotions. The promotional avenues are limited for judges who join as civil judges in the district judiciary. Some judges join as civil judge and retire as civil judge. While the Shetty Commission had highlighted the problem and suggested a weighted system, but it was rejected by the Supreme Court on ground that the introduction of a roster system would resolve the issue. It hasn't done so. Gender sensitization. Nationally, the share of women in the district judiciary has crossed 33%. However, a conducive work environment to welcome women judges is missing due to a lack of residential accommodations, separate washrooms in courtroom premises, creches, and security. Technology. Most of the judges of the district judiciary are not well equipped with technology for the purposes of research, conducting trials. While the libraries is diminishing from residential offices, judges are not properly trained to avail e-library and e-journal facilities, and in some cases, they're not even available. Incentives to join judicial services. Young and bright students from national law schools seldom join judicial services, and they do not see promotional avenues and lucrative monetary benefits. I urge everyone on the dais to urgently address the persistent issues being faced by judges of the trial and district and session courts, who are the backbone of our judicial system. It is time for us to make our justice delivery system more efficient, stronger, and viable. I echo the words of Andrew Jackson, who is often praised as an advocate for ordinary citizens, and I quote, "All the rights secured to the citizens under the Constitution are worth nothing in a mere bubble, except guaranteed to them by an independent and virtuous judiciary." Thank you very much.
तो आपने सुना, कपिल सिब्बल ने कई मुद्दे उठाए। कपिल सिब्बल ने जिला न्यायपालिका के राष्ट्रीय सम्मेलन में कहा कि स्वतंत्रता एक संपन्न लोकतंत्र की आधारभूत बुनियाद है और इसे बाधित करने का कोई भी प्रयास लोकतंत्र की गुणवत्ता को प्रभावित करता है। बता दें, इस सम्मेलन का उद्घाटन प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी ने किया था। उन्होंने प्रधान न्यायाधीश सीजीआई डीवाई चंचूण का हवाला दिया, जो अक्सर कहते हैं कि उच्चतर न्यायपालिका जमानत के मामलों से दबी है, क्योंकि निचली अदालतों के स्तर पर जमानत एक अपवाद प्रतीत होती है। उन्होंने हाल ही में दिए गए कुछ अदालती फैसलों के बारे में बात की जो जमानत नियत है और जेल अपवाद के सिद्धांत का पालन करते हैं। उन्होंने कहा कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने अब विशेष अधिनियमों के संबंध में भी कई हालिया फैसलों में इस सिद्धांत को दोहराया है, जो दर्शाता है कि इस सिद्धांत का पालन किया जाना चाहिए। सिब्बल ने कहा, मैंने इस मुद्दे पर इसलिए जोर दिया है क्योंकि किसी देश का लोकतांत्रिक ढांचा इस बात पर निर्भर करता है कि अदालत हमारी राजनीति के संदर्भ में स्वतंत्रता के महत्व को स्वीकार करती है या नहीं। स्वतंत्रता एक संपन्न लोकतंत्र की आधारभूत बुनियाद है। इसे बाधित करने का कोई भी प्रयास हमारे लोकतंत्र की गुणवत्ता को प्रभावित करता है।